Many destinies are devastated today because they lack direction. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. But wisdom is not about common sense. The wisdom of God is on common sense. It's walking in the light of scriptures with delight. People just start doing anything anyhow. It's not every key that opens every door. It has to be the right key for the door to open to you. You don't use your car key to go and be opening your box, because with God all things are possible. Where you stand tomorrow is determined by your quality of commitment today. And this commitment has to do with investment of time, energy, and resources. So your wearing coat and suit and ties has nothing to life. It is what you contribute to life that determines your worth. You don't have an enemy. You have been the enemy of yourself for too long. Your lack is not a function of how much you are earning. It's how well you are responding to covenant demands. When I was earning 300 naira a month, married with a child, we were not in lack. I'm sure you'll agree with me, you will never be the age you are now twice. So in case you are 20, you will only be 20 years once. If you are 25, you'll be 25 years once. You may look like sweet 16, but the sense of your body is reading accurately. The situation in the nation is not your problem. It is your own covenant position with God that determines your overall well-being. I'm sure you all agree that pride goes before destruction. I'm sure you agree that God resists the proud and he gives more grace to the humble. So the pride in your heart might be the undoing of your destiny without knowing. And they ask you to do something in your department and you feel, myself, they should know me, should I cannot do this kind of thing. There are many proud folks. I saw one proud road mender on the railroad to my house in Gawan Estate. I asked my driver to give him 5 naira and he looked at him. 5 naira, I said, collect it from him. You don't owe him a dime, but pride went against him. That was when his business closed on that road. All he needed to say is, thank you, sir. And next time I say, give him 10 naira. Next time I say, come, what do you do? He might even have started a business today, but pride got him even off the road. And you know, pride does not show on the face. Its residence is in the heart. Most of the things, the reason why many people run bankrupt before the month is over is pride. They eat beyond their size. When he goes to a restaurant, he commanded things to be supplied that is far beyond his status. And he settled down suffering under the plague and the virus of pride. Pride has many ways of expressing itself. All you need is humility if you want a dignified destiny. I've been traveling for years, but I've never bought a piece of suit from any country in the world that I travel and I say, how much is this suit? Why? It's available in Nigeria. There's nothing about the one you bought from Italy. It's no difference. If they sew it in Lagos, they can also put Italy behind it. It doesn't make a difference. I pray today for the spirit of meekness and humility to pave way for fulfillment of destiny for you.